We want everyone to join us on Saturday night, July 10th, for perhaps the most important show we've ever done. Yes, we are moving from disclosure to diplomacy. We're coming together to create planetary and interplanetary relationships. And we have an amazing group of people from all over the world that are making this happen, led by our beloved Mark Sims, who will conclude the evening with a CE6 meditation. You'll hear live from Danny Sheehan telling you all the latest about his meetings with the Inspector General and the Pentagon. Meet Stephen Bassett, who for 15 years has been the executive director of the Paradigm Research Group and has done a tremendous job in raising awareness about what's really going on. Whitley Strieber, the best-selling author and the grandfather of this entire movement, will be with us live. You'll also meet new friends, such as Rebecca Hardcastle Wright and Sylvain Rochon, who is one of the directors of the Alliance for Extra-Terrestrial Diplomatic Contact, and they have raised $50 million to build the first embassy for our galactic friends. Our co-producer and co-host is the great Alan Steinfeld, author of the new book, Making Contact. You'll also meet Marina, Seren, an experiencer and fascinating woman coming to us from Europe. And as always, some of our favorite musicians, and we are blessed to have with us both Cornflower and Larisa Stow. Debra and I will be hosting, and we look forward to seeing you on Saturday night, July the 10th. Extraordinary individual this man is. He has been fighting the good fight for so long, for decades. And it seems like whenever there is a significant case where the little guy is going up against the government or against the corporation, Danny's the one representing people. And he's been doing it a long, long time. Karen Silkwood and Pentagon Papers way back, and Standing Rock, and of course where we're going to be primarily talking about now with Lou Elizondo.
So he contacted me in that capacity, knowing full well who I was and what my objectives were. And so we had a series of meetings, and he was satisfied that I should represent him. And so we launched a counterattack against the Pentagon and prepared a major complaint against the people inside the Pentagon and the Defense Department, arguing that they were lying.
We have tackled many strange stories on 60 Minutes, but perhaps none like this. It's the story of the U.S. government's grudging acknowledgement of unidentified aerial phenomena, UAP, more commonly known as UFOs. After decades of public denial, the Pentagon now admits there's something out there, and the U.S. Senate wants to know what it is. The Intelligence Committee has ordered the Director of National Intelligence and the Secretary of Defense to deliver a report on the mysterious sightings by next month.
In night vision video from a Navy destroyer, a mysterious flying triangle above the deck of the ship. The Pentagon confirming the images obtained by documentary filmmaker Jeremy Corbell were taken by Navy personnel, expected to be a part of a report on unidentified aerial phenomenon to be presented to Congress this summer. But some of the objects go beyond just flying in the sky. One shows a spherical object dipping into the ocean, similar to an incident in Puerto Rico where an object was tracked buzzing an airport, then flying into the water, popping back out before appearing to split into two and disappearing. Over the last several weeks, some of the nation's top former intelligence officials have been raising eyebrows.
Look at that thing. It's rotating.